Good evening. We're going to speak today about men and women according to Judaism. It's a very, very known opinion in the secular world that the woman is a second degree citizen according to the Torah. And that's a very, very big mistake. Not only that it's not true, in many aspects of the life of the woman, she is considered higher than the man in the eyes of God. I give one example before we start. The most important thing in a Jewish family is the house. A woman in Judaism, according to the Torah, she is called, she has a nickname. Besides calling her Isha, how the Gemara call a woman? Beito, the house of a man. The house of the man. Why they call the woman the house? Why they call her the house? Because everything in a house is determined on her quality. She's a kosher woman, most likely your house will be kosher. If she's not a kosher woman, who knows what can happen in this house? She is the foundation of the house. So the Torah say, Beto means his wife. And the most important thing in a Jewish family is the future, the raising the children. Making sure your children will follow the path of God and the truth that He gave us in Mount Sinai 3,322 years ago. Where do we see that it's the most important thing? Just before Abraham died, what does Hashem say about him? I love Abraham. Do you know what it is? Do you know what it means from billions and billions of people that ever lived in this world? The book of God, He took your name and He puts you in big places in the Torah, whole stories about your life, who are you, who is your wife, your son, what you did, your conversation with God. He became an integral part of the book of God. Not talking here, this is something very important. But there's one thing to be mentioned in the book of God, which is a great thing, but there is an extra level now, when God writes with His own signature in His book, Ahavti et Avraham, I love Abraham. And he'd say the two reasons why he love him. Because he will teach his children the Torah that I taught him. That's why I love him. Understand? So a father that doesn't do it to his children, right away lose his kindness in the eyes of God. Ahavti et Avraham. Why? Because he will teach the children my Torah. And because he himself kept all my Torah. Ekev asher shamar et torotai, mitzvotai v'chukotai. Two reasons. One, he was preaching right to his children. Second, wasn't only giving them speeches and leave the opposite like some parents do. Was telling them what to do and set a perfect example. So, Avraham Avinu, Hashem loved him because he passed the Torah to the future generations. In the Jewish family, who is in charge of raising the children? Who is all the time with them? Who is in charge of raising them, feeding them, teaching them how to make brachot, talking to them about modesty, giving them an example how you read Tehillim, how you pray? Who is with them all the time? The mother. Since they are babies, right away they are attached to the mother. Who has a more important job in a Jewish family, the father or the mother? Such big responsibility Hashem put in the hands of the women. It's not a coincidence. What is it like? Imagine the Israeli army. What's more important in the Israeli army? A pilot of F-16 who fly and bomb the atomic nuclear facility in Iraq and soon in Iran, Bezrat Hashem? Or a little person that writes orders for the milk, for the bread to the kitchen, to make sure, you know, there's enough cucumbers and that they clean the kitchen and the bathroom is clean and has toilet paper. It's also important. You need cucumbers, you need toilet paper. But someone who compared this guy to this pilot that could be life of millions depend on his hand, to compare this to this, you have to be a total ignorant. Everybody understand this one is more important in the operation. If God put the future of the family, the future of the Jewish nation, Bet Yaakov, the women, in their hands, that means not only they're not second-class citizens, they are actually coming even before the men.